All right, angle addition postulate. That word's weird, but don't worry. Basically, all it is you're adding to get the sum of all the angles. Okay, so that's what we're trying to find. Because I didn't name it. Some dude probably thousands of years ago came up with angle addition postulate. That's how you say that, but you don't need to know that. Just know that's what we're gonna do. Okay, so this says if D is the interior of ABC, so D's inside the bigger angle. Okay, then angle A, B, D plus angle D, B, C will equal the big angle. Angle A, B, C. Okay, so let me show you what that just said with multiple colors.
What do I have up there? Red? Have a red one up there?
Alright, so what that just said is if we take ABD, so that's this up here, ABD, right? And we add it with D, maybe DBC, you're going to get this whole thing here. Would that be true? If you add red and green, you get blue.
Wait, you're adding them and you get blue?
If you add them together, you would get the sum of the whole big angle.
I don't know.
Yeah,
I did.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
So part one plus part two equals the whole thing.
Yeah, you split it right in half, so then you add them.
Correct. So that's basically what that means right there. Note to self, don't use green. Can't see. Anyways, okay. So an example, use the diagram below to answer questions 1 and 2. So if ABD, so ABD is 48 and DBC is 78, what is ABC? So what way that we would find that is you would do 48
plus
78 equals what?
126.
About how we got that. Does that make sense? Just adding two parts together.
Okay.
Mayor Blank, if you're with me.
Oh.
Cool. Alright, so the next one. This says DBC is 74 and ABC, so the whole thing, is 119. We need to find this.
Don't you have to subtract?
Next one.
Yeah.
So what would we do?
Subtract 119.
And what do we get?
45.
Good. Questions there? Good. Pretty straightforward so far?
Yeah.
So now we come down here to number 3.
So what you do right here is...
What are you thinking? We're going to have to write an equation. What is our equation going to equal? So that's where you have to read what this says. This is saying that PQR, which is the whole thing, good.
Equals 141.
Yep. So we know that it's going to equal 141.
Five.
But what equals that? Think back up to here. What did we do?
So it would be 13x plus 4.
Yep. So that's one part of it.
And then 141 and then equals 10x
plus this, right? Because this plus this should give us this, right? So there's our equation. We've got what it equals. Set up to the two parts that they give us. Questions about that? Good? Okay. So now let's do some.
Let's get rid of this. You can't see this.
Okay, so look on the right side of the equal sign. Do we have like terms? What do we have?
So we'll keep the added person and that next to the other.
And what's the?
Was gives you 23.
Okay.
So, and then you add 11 to, now you can add 4 to negative 11.
Good, so then our other one would be?
Four.
Negative 11. So what is 4 minus 11? Negative 7. Okay, so now you have it set up where it's a two-step equation. And what'd you say, Chris?
Add
7 to both sides.
And then you got 148 equals 23.
And you said divide by 23 to get x by itself. Good. It's not 11, it's 1. I put the wrong number.
Right.
That's me.
Boy.
Yeah.
So that changes that.
Alright.
Okay, so what's 4 minus 1?
4 minus 1 is 3.
It's 3.
So then
now we're rolling.
So then 3 to those 6.
Positive 3. So then we're gonna what? Subtract 3, right?
Sure.
Should have given us a
positive. Yeah, positive.
Yeah. Try 1. Try 138 divided by 23.
6.
There we go. So on that line over here, we can put x equals 6. Now, is that the only thing they're asking for?
No.
Unfortunately, it is not. So we got to plug the 6 in to find our two lines. So the first one,
13 times 6
yep.
plus 4.
Which is what?
82.
Okay.
And then 10 times 6
equals what?
59.
Now, the easiest way to check to see if those numbers are right, add those two together. What do you get? 82 and 59. If you add them together, what do you get?
141.
And that's what we needed, right? So there you go. Do that. Relatively. We'll do another one together. I already got, Chris, you got that? It says DEF equals 7x plus 4. So that's the whole thing. DEG equals 5x plus 1. And GEF is 23. So how would we set that up? What does the whole thing equal?
23.
Nope.
No.
Careful. Look at what it's telling you. Sometimes, like for this, you might want to write the whole thing out. So you have, I like to do this, so you know it's the whole thing. And then we know this is 5x plus 1, and this is 23. Okay.
So do you even know what it equals?
Mm-hmm. So it equals this, because the whole thing equals that. So 7x plus 4 equals, what are our two sides?
23
and? Step 1 would be combining like terms on the right side. which would be what?
You add 5 to 22.
Not 5. 1. Good, because the 5 has an x.
Oh,
so you have 7x plus 4 equals 24 plus 5x. So now we've combined like terms. Now step 2.
Subtract 5 to 7.
So we're going
to
bring
2.
Good. So we're going to bring 5 to the other side.
2.
We're going to subtract because it's positive. You said this is 2x plus 4. Okay. Now we're going to take away 4. Okay. Last step.
It would be 10.
Good. Because you did what?
Divided.
You divided by 2. X equals 10. Okay, now.
So then you fill in the 10 for everything else.
You're going to plug the 10 back in. Yep, so we do 5x, so 5 times 10 plus 1.
51.
Good. And then 7 times 10.
70.
Plus 4.
74.
Now you just have to figure out which one's which. So D, E, G is 51. D, E, F is 74. Does 21 plus, or does 23 plus 51 give you 74? Yes, right? Because this one's 23, we said this is 51. They should add to get 74, and they do. So those of you at home, I want you to try number 5. I'll help you set it up real quick. Okay? So JKM equals 43. So this is 43. MKL is 8x minus 20. Okay? And the whole thing is going to be 10x minus 11. If we put everything together, you're going to have 43 plus 8x minus 20 equals 10x minus 11. So there's your equation. Those of you working at home, I want you to try that one on your own.